Today with Harriet Gay, and so a special welcome to her family and friends who have gathered today for her baptism, and we'll do that later in the service. Tonight our young adult ministry meets at 7 o'clock. Sunday night at 7 we are meeting at Grand Station, and so this is for college age kids. Come out and join us tonight. Next Sunday we're going to meet at Grand Station, okay? On Wednesday we have Ash Wednesday worship at noon and 7 p.m. And these are, both services are the same with Holy Communion and the imposition of ashes. Please be sure to pay attention to the committee meetings. Worship and Music Committee meeting did get moved from 6:45 to 6:30, so make a note of that. And I hope that the soup supper clipboards have been circulating. Val, would you pass that one right there? There should be one in that front row. Did it already get passed? We are starting soup suppers, not this Wednesday, but next Wednesday. And there are 5 Wednesdays when we will need soup. We usually have about 12 pots. So be sure and check it out if you're a soup maker. If you need help carrying it or anything like that, just let us know. We are collecting personal care items for our Lutheran World Relief personal care kits. There are baskets in the entrance area, and there will be an article in the newsletter that comes out this week with all the specifics. But as you begin to collect those, feel free to bring those and drop them in the baskets. There's also a sign-up sheet for the women's retreat that is coming at the end of the month, and Holy Communion class, which will begin in the middle of March. So please, again, sign up where it's appropriate. Any other announcements before we begin? We are on Facebook Live. And so the camera is back by the audiovisual station. That's not the place to have your personal confidential conversations. And one of the ways you can help spread the good news is check in. If you are on Facebook, simply go to your page and check into your church. And what that does is it just says, Elaine Gamolka checked into Our Savior's Lutheran Church Sunday morning. And your friends say, I didn't know you went to that church, and you're like, yeah, you should come with me sometime. It's a great place. Got it? It's just one of the ways that you can spread the good news. All right, anything else? Let us prepare our hearts for worship. Youth, come on and join the guitarist up front for our call to worship. Thank you.
us free by the truth you now bring us. Shine on me. Shine on me. Shine, Jesus, shine.
Forward for the children's sermon.
I
appearance of the glory of the Lord was like a devouring fire on the top of a mountain in the sight of the people of Israel. Moses entered the cloud and went up on the mountain. Moses was on the mountain for 40 days and 40 nights. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Why are the nations in an uproar?
Why do the peoples utter empty threats?
Why do the kings of the earth rise up in revolt and the princes plot together?
Against the Lord, against the Lord's anointed.
Let us break their yoke, they say.
Let us cast off their bonds from us.
God, whose throne is in heaven, is laughing. Then in wrath, God speaks to them.
And in rage, fills them with terror.
As for me, I have anointed my king.
On Zion, my holy mountain.
Let me announce the decree of the Lord.
He said to me, you are my son. This day I have begotten you.
Ask of me, and I will give you the nations of your inheritance.
And the ends of the earth for your possession.
You shall crest them with an iron rod.
And shatter them like a piece of pottery.
And now your king must be wise.
Be warned, you rulers of the earth.
Submit to the Lord's fear.
And to the bow of worship.
Lest the Lord be angry, and you perish in the sudden blaze of wrath.
Happy are all who take refuge in God.
Chapter 1, verse 16-21. For we did not follow cleverly devised myths when we have made known to you the power and coming of our Lord Jesus Christ, but we have been eyewitness to his majesty. For he received honor and glory from the God the Father, and that voice was conveyed to him by the majestic glory, saying, "This is my Son, my beloved, with whom I am well pleased." We ourselves heard this voice come from heaven, while we were with him on the holy mountain. So we have the prophetic message more fully confirmed. You will do well to be attentive to this as to a lamp shining in a dark place until the day dawns and the morning star rises in your hearts. First of all, you must understand this, that no prophecy of Scripture is a matter of one's own interpretation, because no prophecy ever came by human will, but men and women moved by the Holy Spirit spoke from God. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Thank you.
light the fire in my heart again.
Holy Gospel according to Matthew.
Glory to you, O Lord.
Jesus. Took with him Peter and James and his brother John and led them up a high mountain by themselves. And he was transfigured before them, and his face shone like the sun, and his clothes became dazzling white. Suddenly, there appeared to them Moses and Elijah, talking with him. Then Peter said to Jesus, "Lord, it is good for us to be here. If you wish, I will make three dwellings here, one for you, one for Moses, and one for Elijah." While he was speaking, suddenly a bright cloud overshadowed them. And from the cloud, a voice said, "This is my son, the beloved. With him I am well pleased. Listen to him." When the disciples heard this, they fell to the ground and they were overcome by fear. But Jesus came and touched them, saying, "Get up and do not be afraid." And when they looked up, they saw no one except Jesus himself alone. As they were coming down the mountain, Jesus ordered them, "Tell no one about the vision until after the Son of Man has been raised from the dead." The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, O Christ.
Celia, and one of the more recent changes in my life was the shift from middle school to high school. Now, don't get me wrong, high school is great. There's nothing I love more than having three projects due on the same day. In middle school, you were forced to pay attention and put your phone away in your backpack or in your locker. But in high school, nobody cares if you are sleeping or if you're just on your phone playing games. In high school, when you text your partner 2 days before the project is due and ask them how their part of the project is going, and they reply with "what project," you know that you are completely alone. What I failed to realize while staying up until 2 a.m. finishing the project is that I could have gone to the teacher the other day for help. Instead, I relied on my partner, who, while at the time I thought was helping me, when they were actually just relieving my stress for a while, until, of course, I found out they had done nothing. The kingdom of God is similar in that way. If you focus on giving your attention and your love to something else, it is like trusting your partner to do half of the project they didn't even know existed. If I had gone to the teacher and explained my situation, I wouldn't have had so many late nights spent working. In this case, the teacher represents God. God wants to help you live a faithful life, just like your teacher wants you to pass their class. So, in your transfiguration and in your time of need, turn to God and He just might give you an extra day on your project.
Jordan, and I'm going to tell you all about a time that I went out of my comfort zone and how God helped me with it. When I was transitioning from middle school to high school, I had the option of going into the marching band at Bryan High School. I chose to be a part of the marching band. Being in the marching band takes a lot of time out of your day. We had practices that would feel like hours after school in the heat of September. Sometimes I would want to just leave everything and go home and just quit. But after 2 months, I started to like being in the band more and more. Soon, marching band became my way to get away from all the stress surrounding me and my school and home life. I look forward to playing my instrument on Friday nights in the fall, hearing the crowd cheer, smelling the fresh food at the concession stands, playing the battle of the bands with the opposing marching bands, whatever it may be, and just being able to be a special part of our school spirit. The most special part of marching band was that I had friends and people who genuinely cared about me as a person. Marching on that field every Friday night was a team effort, and you have to support your team members in order for the team to succeed. This simple fact made me feel like I was important for once in my life, and that people actually needed me to help them as much as I needed them in return. Marching band has changed my life for the better, and I will always appreciate the people who were kind to me during my first year and who helped me to become the more confident person I am today. Marching band is truly a huge family, and I am so glad that I am a part of that family now. I would suggest to anyone having any doubts about doing something out of their comfort zone to just go for it, because in the long run, you will change and be able to experience something you have never experienced before. There are people out there who will never leave you behind and will always be there to help in tough situations. You just have to take the risk to find them. Joining marching band has been my risk, and it has turned out to be one of the best decisions I've ever made in my entire life.
Howdy. My name is Wesley Bernhausen. I am the son of my mom and my dad, Mr. and Mrs. Bobby and Angela Bernhausen. I'd like to tell you all the moment of my life that I believe I was transfigured and what I believe got me closer to the Lord. About 5 years ago, my grandmother, Joy Del Grimm, passed away from breast cancer after a hard-fought battle. This was the first death in my family. I had never experienced a death before in my life. What was once a life of happiness and no worries turned to a life of sadness and darkness. I didn't want to get up, and I didn't want to do anything in the morning. I didn't know what to do. 2 years later, my grandfather, Billy Graham, passed away. This was another big blow to me. I already hated to do anything anymore, so this made things worse. Not even 3 months later, my other grandmother, Elizabeth Bernhausen, passed away. I lost two grandparents in less than 3 months, even though I begged and prayed to God every day. God, please don't let me lose my last grandparents. I begged every day, but it didn't work. I asked God why he had done this. I was angry at him, and I even questioned him. I was depressed, and I hated to do anything. I never got out of bed for anything. Eventually, my family helped me get over my sadness of the passings. It took quite a while. I asked God to forgive me, even though I had gotten angry and questioned him. He forgave me, and I now know that God is loving, and all of this happened for a reason. God had done even more than I had asked him. He showed me ways to stay positive. He led me to music that helped me when I felt depressed. He gave me friends who kept me positive and would make me laugh when I needed to. I thank the Lord for these things, and I promise to never get angry at him or question him again. Thank you.
Good morning. I'm Lauren, and recently one of the biggest transitions that I've had to deal with in my life was transitioning into senior year. Everybody told me that senior year was going to be super easy and that it's going to be a breeze. It hasn't been, but I'm doing okay. When I went into senior year, my plan was to just kind of do what I needed to do and get it done and not try to do a bunch of extra things, don't really try to make a bunch of extra friends. I had some friends going into senior year, but I hadn't really found my group and that group of people that I felt comfortable with and that I hung out with a lot. So my main focus was just like to do my schoolwork and to get it over with as fast as I could without like, you know, necessarily making a bunch of friends. And that changed when last semester, towards the end of the semester, my school's theater production company decided that they were going to put on the musical Beauty and the Beast. And I, that was something kind of out of my comfort zone. I was in choir, but I hadn't really done theater at this school. And theater people are kind of interesting. They're outgoing, and so just trying to jump into that as someone who's not super outgoing was difficult. But I auditioned, and I got a role. And when I got that role, I was like, oh no, now I'm really committed to it. Now I really have to put effort in, and I can't back out now. And so the first few rehearsals and like the first probably month of rehearsals, I didn't have a lot of friends, and I was just kind of, I kind of regretted auditioning and stuff. But as it went on, as the nights got longer and the rehearsals got more stressful and times got more busy, I started really building relationships with the people that I was around, and those relationships that I had promised myself I wasn't gonna build at the beginning of the year. And I realized that God had been pulling me to do this because he knew that I was going to meet some of my best friends. And I can honestly say that this is the happiest I've been since I moved. I have so many new friends, and I totally do not regret it. I've continued to do theater because of that. And so I think that God used this musical experience as a way to transfigure me and to show me that, like, I do need these friends and that I do need to make the most of my senior year. So. Thank you.
Good morning. I'm Lauren Bernhausen. I'm the daughter of Bobby and Angela Bernhausen, and I'm a current senior at College Station High School. Transfiguration can be kind of a tricky word to understand, so I decided I would look it up, and it is defined as a complete change of form or appearance into a more beautiful or spiritual state. The word that sticks out to me there is change. I'm not a fan of change. I've lived in College Station my whole life, going to the same church, been surrounded by the same people, so change really scares me, and I especially don't like being blindsided by it. Growing up, I was constantly around my grandparents. They lived in Brenham, which is only about a 45-minute drive, so my weekends were spent at their house or they were at mine. I know that there are a lot of Brenham connections here, so some of you may know them. Their names were Billy and Joy Grimm, or as I knew them, Popo and Mimi, and Elizabeth Bernhausen, aka my Nana. My grandparents were some of my absolute favorite people. I truly admired them and all that they had to work for in their lives. I loved spending my weekends in Brenham playing outside in my grandparents' land with all of my cousins. All of my favorite childhood memories were both there. My Popo was a hardworking man who taught all the grandkids how to shoot a gun, loved barbecuing, being outside, and anything that involved his family. My Mimi taught us all how to bake, cook, and most importantly, how to love the Lord. And my Nana, well, she could play a nasty game of dominoes. I viewed my grandparents as these invincible people that could take on anything. Unfortunately, as many of us know, cancer can take everything from a person. On August 6, 2015, my Mimi and Poe found out exactly 90 minutes apart that they both had cancer. My Poe was diagnosed with bladder cancer, and my Mimi was told she had breast cancer for the third time. After this, things went downhill very quickly. I watched as the doctors told my grandma that there was nothing that they could do for her and watched her go on hospice. We spent every weekend by her side because we didn't know when it would be the last. A little over a month after her diagnosis, my beautiful grandma, Joy Del Grimm, went to be with the Lord on September 9, 2015. This was heartbreaking for me. I cried every single night and didn't know how to handle myself. I remember telling my mom once that my heart physically hurt and felt broken from losing my grandma. As hard as my Mimi's death was, we knew we had to remain strong for my grandpa. Not only was he still fighting his own cancer, but now he was having to grieve his wife of almost 50 years. He had to start chemo treatments and even get his bladder removed. The hardest part for me was watching him suffer. I watched him lose his hair, lose a lot of weight, and could feel his brokenness. We loved on him so much during this time, but he was still so heartbroken and sick. On January 5th, 2017, my grandpa Billy Ray Grimm was released from his pain and went to be reunited with Jesus and his wife. I thought my Mimi's death was hard, but this one hit me way harder. Once again, my heart just ached and felt broken. The stages of grief are painful and hard to comprehend, but I couldn't even finish one of the stages before being hit with another. We lost my Nana, Elizabeth Bernhausen, on March 14, 2017, to pancreatic cancer. I never felt so broken in a life, and alone in my life. I lost all three of my grandparents to cancer in the span of 18 months. Talk about change. I went through all the stages of grief, but truly denial and isolation hit me the hardest. I stopped talking about it because it was just too painful. I couldn't understand why God could put me through all of this and in such a short time period. How could he take away all of my best friends and make me watch them suffer? I was angry for a long, long time. Nobody around me understood what I was going through, and I had to grow up extremely fast. I continued to go to church, but didn't see any purpose in it. I didn't want anything to do with this God that caused me so much pain. Eventually, I stumbled along the verse, Psalm 27:14, "Wait for the Lord, be strong, and let your heart take courage." I realized that the Lord was waiting for me. God was waiting for his lost child to return home and to realize that everything happens for a reason. This took quite a while for me to realize, but I eventually got there. I understood that God would never give me more than I could handle, and that this ultimately made me stronger. I was also hit with the realization that all the pain I was feeling was nothing compared to what Jesus went through. He suffered the physical pain of carrying the cross and the unimaginable emotional pain of carrying the weight of the whole world's sins on his shoulders. And how lucky are we that Jesus went through this pain so that we could join him and our loved ones in heaven someday so soon. Although I still have days of weakness where I just miss my grandparents so, so much, I'm reminded that they are out of pain and that I will see them again thanks to Jesus dying on the cross. And what a wonderful day that will be. Not only was my life changed, but it was also transfigured to make me a stronger disciple of the Lord. Even though it was truly heartbreaking and the hardest thing I've ever gone through, I know that my grandparents would be proud of me for getting through this tough and life-changing time without them.
Thank you.
into the hallway because you're going to be bringing forward the water for me, okay? So any children or youth that are here, please go into the hallway for me, okay? There'll be somebody back there to help you. God, who is rich in mercy and love, gives us a new birth into a living hope through the sacrament of baptism. By water and the word, God delivers us from sin and death and raises us to new life in Jesus Christ. We are united with all the baptized in the one body of Christ, anointed with the gift of the Holy Spirit, and joined in God's mission for the life of the world. Sponsor, would you please present? Called by the Holy Spirit, trusting in the grace and love of God, parents, do you desire for to have Harriet baptized into Christ? As you bring Harriet to receive the gift of baptism, you are entrusted with responsibilities to live with her among God's faithful people, to bring her to the Word of God and the Holy Supper, to teach her the Lord's Prayer, the Creed, and the Ten Commandments, to place her against the Holy Scriptures and nurture her in faith and prayer so that she may learn to trust God, proclaim Christ through word and deed, care for others and the world God made, and work for justice and peace. It's a lot to ask. Do you promise to help your child and your children grow in the Christian faith and life? Sponsor. Do you promise to nurture Harriet in the Christian faith as you are empowered by God's Spirit and to help her live in the covenant of baptism and in communion with the church? Congregation, people of God, do you promise to support Harriet and pray for her in her new life in Christ?
We do.
I ask you not to profess your faith in Christ Jesus, but to have sin and confess the faith of the church. Do you renounce the devil and all the forces that defy God? Do you renounce the powers of this world that rebel against God? Do you renounce the ways of sin that draw you from God? Congregation, you may join with us. Do you believe in God the Father?
I believe in God the Father Almighty, creator of heaven and earth.
Do you believe in Jesus Christ, the Son of God?
I believe in Jesus Christ, God's only Son, our Lord, who was conceived by the Holy Spirit, born of the Virgin Mary, suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and was buried. He descended to the dead. On the third day, he rose again. He ascended into heaven. He is seated at the right hand of the Father, and he will come to judge the living and the dead.
Do you believe in God, the Holy Spirit?
I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and the life everlasting.
The Lord be with you.
And also with you.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right to give our thanks and praise.
thanks, O God, from the beginning your Spirit moved over the waters, and by your word you created the world, calling forth life in which you took delight. Through the waters of the flood you delivered Noah and his family. Through the sea you led your people Israel from slavery into freedom. At the river your son was baptized by John and anointed with the Holy Spirit. By the baptism of Jesus' death and resurrection, you set us free from the power of death and raise us up to live in you. Pour out your Holy Spirit, the power of your living word, that those who are washed in the waters of baptism may be given new life. To you be given honor and praise through Jesus Christ our Lord, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, now and forever. Harriet Genevieve Gagg, I baptize you in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. Amen.
Belong to Christ in whom you have been baptized. Alleluia.
Let us pray. We'll give you thanks, O God, that through water and the Holy Spirit you give your daughters and sons new birth, cleanse them from sin, and raise them to eternal life. Sustain Harriet with the gift of your Holy Spirit, the Spirit of wisdom and understanding, the Spirit of counsel and might, the Spirit of knowledge and the fear of the Lord, the Spirit of joy in your presence, both now and forever.
Amen.
Harriet, child of God, you have been sealed with the Holy Spirit and marked with the cross of Christ. Let us welcome the newly baptized.
We welcome you into the body of Christ and into the mission we share. Join us in giving thanks and praise to God and bearing God's creative and redeeming word to all the world. So with you.
wonder you formed us in our mother's womb, and from Mother Earth you bring forth this bread and wine. We place them on your table, together with our lives and with all that you have made. Open the heavens to us and pour out your spirit. We wait for your mercy. We long for your peace. We hunger and thirst for Jesus Christ, our banquet of life. Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And also with you.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right to give God thanks and praise.
In the night in which he was betrayed, our Lord Jesus took bread. He gave thanks, he broke it, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take and eat. This is my body given for you. Do this for the remembrance of me." And again, after supper, he took the cup. He gave thanks. And he gave it to all to drink, saying, "This cup is the new covenant in my blood, which is shed for you and for all people for the forgiveness of sin. Do this in remembrance of me." Let us pray the prayer our Lord has taught us to pray.
Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory, forever and ever.
Seated. Here is the Lamb of God who takes away the sin of the world. Come to the table of mercy and grace. Please remember that this table is the table of the Lord, and all are welcome.
Together to worship you. I'm
and keep you in his grace.
Amen.
Let us pray. Faithful God, you have kept your promise to us in this meal, nourishing us with the gift of salvation. Now send your servants forth in peace, that we may testify to your goodness and share the hope that is ours in Jesus Christ, our Savior and Lord.
Amen.
Receive the benediction. You want to do the benediction?
Yes.
May Christ, the wisdom and power of God, and the source of our life together, keep you united in mind and purpose, and the blessing of Almighty God, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit be with you always. Amen.
Amen.
Ron on the bass, and Jordan on the drums, and